Integration by partial fractions. How does it happen? Integration by partial fraction. See, when you are aware of a px by qx form, that is the ratio of two polynomials, this is called the rational function. Here px and qx both are polynomial and this cannot be zero. So if the degree of this px, the numerator, is less than the degree of qx, the rational function is called proper rational function. Otherwise, it will be called as improper. That is, if the degree of px is greater than the degree of qx, it will be an improper rational function. Now, we have to reduce this to such a form so that we can solve it using integration. So, p by x and q by x, if it is improper, we divide. We do this, right? Px. So, the remainder will come, the quotient will come, and the two values can be combined together or should be placed like this, in this way, tx plus p1x by qx. You will understand it when I am going to the example. Just see that we have to divide it. This tx is nothing but the polynomial in x, and this is now a proper rational function. So, we have made a proper rational function and we know how to solve it. But tx is another polynomial which we have got here. So, how to integrate when we have reduced it? We can integrate it because we have two parts now. We have integrand as a sum of simpler rational functions. And now, we can solve it using partial fraction decomposition. Partial fraction decomposition. And when this form is there, the different parts will be lot easier to solve because we have already know the methods to solve them. For example, if this is px plus q by x minus say x minus b, we have already seen how to do it. We have to divide, but there is no problem since we have the actual forms how to represent a rational function in the form of a partial fraction. If this is px by q, these are two linear values, or you can say linear equations. Then it will be a by x minus a plus b by x minus b. If it is x minus a square, so it becomes not linear but quadratic type. But the partial fraction will be a by x minus a, then b by x minus a whole square. If these are three factors, x minus a, x minus b, x minus c, a by b by c by. Here you have twice x minus a whole square. The thing is similar like this, but here you have x minus a twice. Same thing will be done, a by x minus a, but here b by x minus a whole square plus c by x minus b. In this case, it will be a by x minus a plus bx plus c by x square, because this is linear, this is quadratic. For linear, we use only one for any variable, but for quadratic, we use bx plus c. So, let us solve it, dx by x plus 1, x plus 2. We know just now that 1 by x plus 2 x plus 1 can be written as a by x plus 1 b by x plus 2. Now let us solve it. How to solve it? I'll show you how to solve it. This becomes a x plus 2 then plus b x plus 1 divided by this one x plus 1 x plus 2. Now when we equate, this gets cancelled. Let us see this, what it gives us: ax plus 2a plus bx plus b. Now combine the like terms, that is a plus b x plus 2a plus b. Now here we see, if we equate, there is no x term. So a plus b will be 0, and 2a plus b, there is a constant term. So 2a plus b will be equal to 1. So this is how we equate. A plus b will be 0, 2a plus b equal to 1. When we solve this, we get a equal to 1 and b equal to minus 1. So, the integrand becomes quite easy. This is, we have replaced a and b, the value we got, and we integrate it now. This is nothing but log x plus 1, this is nothing but log x plus 2, because minus sign is there, log a minus log b is log a by b. This is how we solve it. Now, this form of equation is there and we know how to do it. First of all, we have to, this is not a proper rational function because the degree, they are same. So what you have to do here is you have to divide it properly and you see what the result will be. It will be 1 plus 5x minus 5 by x square minus 5x plus 6. How you get it? How did you actually form this type of equation? Let me tell you how did we arrive here. We are dividing it. X square minus 5x plus 6. Here is x square plus 1. So this is x square. If you want to get x square, you have to multiply it by 1. So this gets x square minus 5x plus 6. Change the sign. This cancels. This becomes, if this is minus, you can just, this is x square plus 1 and now you are subtracting it. And this is x square minus 5x minus 6. 1 minus 6 is what? 1 minus 6 is minus 5. What is this? X square plus 1. So this is also a constant. This has combined with this. So 5x will come like this only. So how can we write this? 1 plus 5x minus 5 by x square minus 5x plus 6. If you solve it, you will get this only. So let us factor this. This will be x minus 2, x minus 3. So this we can integrate easily. But how to get integration of this? We'll use the partial fraction. A by x minus 2 for this, b by x minus 3 for this. Then again, the way I explained earlier, you have to just solve it for a and b. Like terms, like a plus b equal to 5, 3a plus 2b equal to 5, these two equations you'll get. A is minus 5, b is 10 if you solve it. So you get 1 minus 5 by x minus 2 plus 10 minus 10 by x minus 3. Now integrate these three. This is simply x. This is log x minus 2. This is log x plus 3. 10 is there. So this is the solution. How to solve this? This can easily be written as, because this is twice, this is square. So a by x plus 1, b by x plus 1 whole square. How about this? It will be written just like this, c by x plus 3. Now again, just you have to solve. Means take the LCM. It will be like this only, and a goes with x plus 1 whole square and x plus 3, and b goes with x plus 1 and x plus 3, and c goes with x plus 1 whole square and x plus 1. So you just have to take x plus 1 because these are common. So this will be the solution. Means I'm just saying that you just have to take the common terms and equate it to the, because x square is 0 here. X square is 0, say 0 x square. This is like this. So x square term will be 0 and the x term will be, first a plus c will be 0 and 3, that is the x term will be 4a plus b plus 2c, and the third term will be minus 2, that is 3a plus 3b plus c will be minus 2. So you get a, b, c if you solve it. It's quite easy to solve. Then our main concern is this, how to integrate this. So we have got a, b, c now. Take these out, means these are constants. Now integrate x plus 1, integrate x plus 1 whole square, integrate this 1 by x plus 3. This will be log x plus 1, this will be log x plus 3. How about this? X plus 2, x plus 1 whole square. You can take it in the numerator, x plus 1 minus 2. So minus 2 x plus 1 minus 3. So it and minus 1 plus 1, sorry. Minus 1 plus 1, so it will be minus 1. So this will be nothing but minus 2 by x plus 1. This is what you see. Minus 2, because this is 2, 2 gets cancelled. You will only be left with this 5. And you already have this. So when you solve it, this can be combined because the factors are common. So you can take 11 by 4 out and log a minus log b is log a by b, and this will remain like this. Next is x square by x square plus 1, x square plus 4. Now this is not in the standard form. You have to convert it first so that you can go ahead with the partial fraction. Take x square equal to y. This x square, just put y everywhere. Now this can be written in the form of partial fraction. This is a by y plus 1 plus b by y plus 2. Just solve it, you get a and b for this. I hope you will be able to solve it. This is just simple, you are equating with the like terms. Now this is what we get, but because we have assumed y to be x square, we'll replace this by x square. Now this will become a standard integral. Dx by x square plus a square, that is tan inverse x by a. This is again tan inverse x by a, that is 2. Half. Oh, because you have to see that 4 by 3, when you do this, this is 1 by 2. Here, because 10, 1 by a was 1, so nothing has come here, but it will come 1 by 2 here. So, this is the simpler solution. When you want to solve this 5, don't worry about 5, it is just equivalent to x only. So, just place y equal to sin 5 here. And when you put y equal to sin y, dy will be sin y, sin phi, differentiation is cos phi. So, dy will be equal to cos phi d phi. Now, put y equal to sin phi. So, sin phi will be y. Y. This can also be written as cos square is 1 minus sin square y. So, it will be 1 minus sin square y, 1 minus y square. And this will become cos phi dy if is dy. And this will be 3y minus 2. Now, just solve it. You get y square minus 4y plus 4. Now, this is y minus 2 whole square. This is simply y minus 2 whole square. If you solve it, this will be the result. But the thing is, now you can write it in the form of partial fraction. 3y minus 2 by y minus 2 whole square will be a by y minus 2 plus b by y minus 2 whole square. Again, just solve it. Equating with 3y minus 2, you get a and b. A will be 3, b will be 4. This is the equation you will get. I hope you will try it by yourself. This is quite easy. We are interested in the integration part. So, when we are given this e, a and b, we have found out, just place a and b. Now, integration of y minus 2 in 1 by y minus 2 and integration of y minus 2 whole square is quite easy. This will be log y minus 2 and this will be nothing but we have just seen in the previous example, minus 1 by y minus 2. Now, y was taken as sin phi. So, you have to replace sin phi and this is the solution. Okay, one more thing here. Since this sin phi minus 2 is in absolute, because log always comes in absolute. If you write 2 minus sin phi vary from minus 1 to 1. So, this will always be positive. So, you can just ignore this sign and you can place 2 minus sin phi because this is log will never come, the value inside log will never come negative. If you put it this way, 2 minus sin phi. Now, other way is x square plus x plus 1 by this. So, again, a by x plus 2 and then because this is quadratic type. So, bx plus c by x square plus 1. Now, again, a into this, b into this and just equate it, the result with this one, the like term, that is the exponent of x, the coefficient of x square, coefficient of x and coefficient of, of course, this, there is no coefficient, coefficient of x to the power 0 basically. So, it is a constant. So, you get this kind of equation and a, b, c if you equate and you get a, b, c, you can easily solve it. So, our idea is to put it in this way, right? We have just put it in this way. This we can easily get and you just have to solve this so you can get 1 by 5 out and this will be 2x plus 1 by x square plus 1. This is simply integration. So, log x plus 2 will come and we'll take these two, this one and this one separately. So, this is 2x by x square plus 1, this is 1 by x square plus 1. 2x by x square plus 1 is nothing but log x square plus 1. If you take this as t, this will be nothing but dt. Right? So, 2x dx will be dt and this will be t. So, log. And this is 1 by x square plus 1 square. So, 1 by 2a. A is 1. So, 1 by a, not 2a. 1 by a. So, 1 by a is 1. So, nothing will come here. But it will be 10 inverse x by a. X by 1 is only x. So, this is the solution of this question.